In our previous videos, we covered how to clean your ionizer and develop a strong maintenance program for your ionization equipment. If you haven't seen those videos, we'll drop some links in the description below. In this video, I'm going to show you how to calibrate your Botron intelligent ionizer. Now, if I'm being honest, depending on the brand of ionizer you have, calibrating them can be a little bit of a pain in the you-know-what. It's going to take either two people, which is costly, or you can do it solo. But doing this by yourself, you'll quickly find it takes a lot of time as you're bouncing back and forth between your charge plate monitor and static field meter while making micro adjustments to your ionizer. The nice thing about the Botron intelligent ionizer is that it comes with a built-in continuous monitor and it displays ion balance in real time. This means that you can calibrate your ionizers by yourself and very quickly. I'm Keith with Botron. Now let's get to work. Our intelligent ionizers have a software offset and mechanical adjustment. Each are able to swing the output of the positive and negative energy coming from the ionizer. The software offset is found in the menu and can be adjusted on the interface. The mechanical adjustment, better understood as true calibration, it can be found on the backside of the ionizer, labeled Cal. You'll see one per fan depending on the number of fans you have in your ionizer. It's always preferable to adjust calibration mechanically prior to applying software offsets. So before we jump in, to get an accurate adjustment, make sure the software offsets are set to zero. All you need to adjust calibration is a precision flathead driver. Now on the back of the ionizer, inside of the calibration terminal is a trim pot. We'll be turning this while watching the ion balance on the display of the ionizer. The idea is to get this as close to zero as you can. If you find the ionizer doesn't reach zero, it's okay. If needed, you jump back into the menu on the user interface and apply your voltage offset. Now that we have our ionizer in balance, we'll run a quick sanity check with our field meter and make sure our controls and documentation are in line. Hey, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, drop us a comment below and make sure you check out the videos and the links in the description.